That ride is counterflowing, and he doesn't have a helmet. My goodness, what was he thinking? I wonder if he's going to have a license. My feeling is no, that maybe the money went into the bike and not into the license. I don't want to assume, so let's see. And there you go, the rider cannot show a driver's license. So they're requesting for the tow truck to come in and pick up the bike. That's how it goes, right? When there's no mirrors, there's no license most of the time. There's the tow truck and the tow crew, so they'll load that on the back with the car that's already been impounded, most likely for illegal parking the car. If you see an illegally parked vehicle on Magenhauer this early in the morning, it's pretty much guaranteed to be towed away, because most of the time the driver lives several streets away or a few streets away. They will not know MMDA are here, they will not know the tow trucks are here. Only when they come out to their car, they'll realize it's towed. Now, I could be wrong, it's not all the time, but most of the time. Not only is this vehicle parked on a road where it's not allowed, but they're on the pedestrian crossing. So the enforcer's writing out the ticket, and I guess that lady might be the driver, the one that just came out. The crazy thing is that the whole road is clear, and the place they chose to stop is right on the pedestrian crossing. That rider was flagged down for no helmet. He can't show a license, so they're impounding the bike. There's no plate on the back of the bike, and honestly, it looks like it's falling apart. So I'm guessing there's also no registration. So he does have a registration, but it's from 2010. His reasoning is he doesn't go outside. I don't know what he's talking about, because isn't this outside? This is a major road. Look at all the trucks and jeeps and cars and stuff. The enforcer is asking this driver for his license. He just took his motorcycle inside. The crazy thing is, he was on a side street. Him and his passenger don't have a helmet. They came out, looked at the enforcers, stayed there for a couple of seconds, and then continued riding past all of the enforcers and got apprehended. He could have turned around, right? He had the chance. He just, I don't know, he's not thinking, I guess. And he just handed over a license as printed on paper. Of course, that's the responsibility of LTO. They are right now telling people they can use an electronic license. I just hope that every enforcer can really verify that electronic license. Because if not, it's only a matter of time before someone in Recdo starts selling an app that looks exactly the same but produces a fake license. You might have noticed they just flagged down that rider. Neither of them are wearing helmets. That's what I thought. There's a child between them and he cannot show a driver's license, so they'll have to impound it. Of course, the other common problem that enforcers encounter is people who share a license from a brother, cousin, uncle, father, son, and they pretend to be the person. So again, if it's an electronic license, you install it on one phone, two phones, three phones, right? But I'm not against the idea of an electronic license, I'm just saying that I hope it's done the right way. Ah, there you go, when the enforcer told him the motorcycle would be impounded, suddenly he realized he does have a license. The lady still wants to ride with the kid, so the enforcer's advising her they'll have to find an alternative transport, like a tricycle, or jeepney, something like that. Of course, the big complaint from LGUs is that if they do not confiscate the license, people do not pay their penalties. And that's probably why LTO has been confiscating the license for many years also. So honestly, I won't be surprised if you see a huge reduction in the amount of remittance to the National Treasury for penalties if everyone starts using the electronic license. If you notice, every other rider is passing without being stopped. Why? Because they don't have a violation, right? He was only stopped because he wasn't wearing a helmet. They're asking this lady now to remove her stuff from the sidewalk. I can hear a little bit of resistance, but sidewalk is really for pedestrians. And once you give them a little bit of space on the sidewalk, they take more and more and more and more. Usually you'd see two vans parked here, but today it's a Subaru. I think it's some kind of repair shop, forcing pedestrians into the road. That's why the towing crew hooking up to it now. It was already ticketed a while ago, and it doesn't appear to be a driver. You will see this is a very busy road with a lot of pedestrians, all of them forced to walk in the road or in the bicycle lane. And the team just took photos of this tricycle and motorcycle parked on the sidewalk of Commonwealth. I suspect they'll be towed away because usually the drivers never come out. It takes them a long time before they realize MMDA are here. They're usually very far away. If you're wondering what's happening here, they're looking for an engine number, chassis number, anything they can put on the ticket because there's no plate. It just says for registration. I wouldn't be surprised if the plate is inside the compartment. That's what we see on a regular basis. Tricycles are also being taken away by the towing crew now. See that big sign there? No waiting, parking, anytime. And directly underneath it, there's a nice PCX. So the towing crew, well, they were about to take it. Now the rider came out. Maybe he came out because he saw the tow trucks. Well, I can remember a long time ago, the MMDA kept talking to these tricycle drivers over and over again. Parked on the bicycle lane, the road, the sidewalk. Kept telling them not to do it, and they keep getting apprehended. I don't know whether the tickets are being paid. Maybe they are. And I just saw that rider. He doesn't have a helmet. The small girl doesn't have a helmet. He turned around when he saw the enforcers. I hope he would at least take it as a lesson. Just go and buy your daughter a helmet, right? And yourself. How are you going to raise your child if you have an accident and you smash your head on the floor? Right? Devastating. That's what it would be. Or worse, your daughter smashes her head on the floor. It'd be very hard to forgive yourself for that. I was amazed that no one moved this truck. They were given warnings, but I am. So there you go. Now there's an enforcer and they're writing out a ticket for illegal parking. There you go. Someone just said it doesn't work. That's probably why they didn't move it. Sayang. That means the only option is to tow it to clear the sidewalk. At first, I was confused about what this lady was saying. It turns out they have a mini gas station here, and then they sell gas to the trucks. Okay, that's interesting. Or maybe I should say diesel rather than gas. They just flagged down a member of the Janglangakong gang. Unfortunately, unauthorized helmet, that's 3,000 pesos. And slippers, that's another 500 pesos. The reason why I say he's a member of Dilag is the first thing he did is point and say, I'm just going there. That's one more rider. Unfortunately, no helmet, no shoes. But at least he has a driver's license, right? So according to enforcers, this tricycle was ticketed around an hour ago for illegal parking unattended. They said there was no tow truck, so they told him to take it inside. When they came back, it was still parked in the same place. They didn't move it from the road. So this time, tow truck is available, and that's where it's going, up on the tow truck. Imagine, he had a chance because no tow truck was available. He didn't take that chance. He forced him. Forced him to tow it. If he'd have just taken it inside. The riders over here said they're a habal habal, which is also known as an illegal motorcycle taxi. They've all been issued tickets, I guess illegal parking and or obstruction. They don't have a passenger, so you can't actually ticket them for a habal habal or calorum. Although, just to clarify, not all of the riders here identified themselves as habal habal. And in fact, so far, all of them have been able to show license registration, except for one, who either can't show or simply won't show. Although this rider was flagged down for not wearing a helmet. Obviously he's pointing, I'm just going there, I just came from here. But as we know, an accident could happen at any time, any place. Many people mistake these RE tricycles for electric. They're not electric, they have a 200cc gasoline motor. They're meant to have a registration and they're meant to have a license. But in reality, what the team see a lot of the time is they're being used for calorum public transport. But in this case, it's just a delivery vehicle.